So today's topic, projectile motion. This is my topic for today. Okay. Then I will draw the diagram. Yeah, we have finished the, no, this is actually the next topic in this question. No more doubts from your end. Okay. I'll first teach, then let us clear all the doubts. So first I'll draw the thing. Many of you know what is a projectile motion, but still I'm just drawing. Okay. So this should be a kind of a curved thing. Okay. With this, I'll draw the vector diagram. So guys, many of you might be wondering what is this diagram, correct? This kind of path is a parabolic path or a parabolic curve. Okay. So I can tell you a lot of examples, but first let us focus on this diagram. Okay. Later on, I'll be telling you each and everything in this. X and Y thing. Uy is equal to u sine theta, and this is ux is equal to u cos theta, and this is my u. So this also will be my ux is equal to u cos theta, the parallel. So please copy down this thing first. Later on, I'll tell you what it is. Once you copied on this diagram, let me know. All of you. And how many of you know about projectile motion? Message me that thing. Or else, how many of you are hearing for the first time? How many of you are hearing for this for the first time? Projectile motion. First time. Okay. Perfect. Okay. So first thing, I'll tell you what is a projectile. And if you copy down this thing, everyone message me, okay, in chat, then only understand. Yeah. If you finish copying it down, then only I can go to the next thing. Done. Okay. Perfect. So first I'll explain what it is, then I'll come back to this diagram. Okay. Projectile. First, I'll tell some examples which you not heard about or which you have in the real life thing. First one, a shot put thrown by an athlete. A shot put thrown by an athlete. So, athlete is here, this guy, correct? He has a shot put at his hand. And then he'll try to throw it in the maximum distance and it will be a parabolic curve, right? It will be a parabolic curve. Correct? So this is the ground level. The ground level I can put. This is the ground level. So this is a classic example of shot put. Not only really shot put, I can give one more example. Javelin. A javelin thrown by the athlete. How many of you don't know javelin? I think everyone knows what is javelin, right? Thrown by an athlete. This is athlete, okay? A-T-H-L-E-T. And the most important thing of a projectile motion, okay, was calculated when atom bomb. I think everyone has heard about the Hiroshima and Nagasaki thing, right? Correct. So on deciding where the bomb should fall, okay, especially for the nuclear weapon and for the weapon missiles, we use projectile motion. So third example, this is actually, what is the reason? This is very important to know this thing. Okay, it's not for the shot put or for javelin. We are doing this for certain other physics thing. So you can write down the third one, a bomb released from aeroplane. Released from aeroplane in level flight. In level flight. So what is a projectile? So a projectile is nothing but it's a body thrown in space and allowed to fall freely under gravity. So if projectile motion in the sense what? Motion in which the body is thrown to space and allowed to fall free fall to the gravity. If it's projectile motion, okay. If the question is projectile, what is projectile motion? Projectile motion. Then you should write down it is a motion. Then this thing. In which the body thrown into space and allowed to fall freely under gravity. Projectile motion. If everyone is done, yeah, I think done. Okay, perfect. Then I'll go back to this. Okay. I'll go back to my first page. where written ux is equal to u cos theta, uy is equal to u sin theta. Projectile motion also I told you what to do. Correct? So let this be O. So from O, what I am doing? I am projecting, or a body is being thrown. Short put meaning, or whatever it is being thrown with initial velocity, then finally free falling to this ground. Correct? So it is a two-dimensional. What? So this is actually 2D. X and Y is why it's 2D. X axis and Y axis is the 2D thing. So this velocity, this is the initial velocity or whatever velocity. This velocity I am dividing into two components. This velocity, I'll write down here. Velocity gets divided into two components. One is the horizontal component. Horizontal component. Which is along the x-axis, okay? Which is the horizontal component, ux equal to u cos theta. And this does not change. This is my first one. Second one is my vertical component. One is horizontal, another is vertical. Vertical in the sense, this particular thing. This one. This vertical component. This vertical component will change. See how it is going and coming down. So vertical thing will change end of the day. Are you getting it or not? Vertical component will change. So that is nothing but my uy or u sin theta, I can put it as. U sin theta, I can put it as. So in horizontal component, I written it as x-axis. And it does not change. Horizontal component does not change. Vertical component is nothing but y-axis. It will change. Why the vertical component will change? Because velocity changes with time. If you ask me why the vertical component change, this is the question. Answer is what? Velocity changes with time. So what is actually changing? What is rate of change of velocity with respect to time? That is acceleration. Correct. Velocity changes with time, which means what? Acceleration. V by T is called what? Acceleration changes with time. And why does it change? It changes due to the acceleration due to gravity. It changes due to acceleration due to gravity. That's it. So guys, the simple two concepts which I want to explain here. Okay, no one will ask you anything. The most important thing is horizontal component is cos theta, vertical component is sine theta. This is the learning from this. Okay, but I have to make sure that whatever I teach, the explanation you should know why one is constant, why other is not constant. Ux is equal to u cos theta. Why this is constant actually? Why it is constant? Can anyone tell me? Why is horizontal component constant? Because in horizontal component, velocity does not change with respect to time. Okay. Hence, the horizontal motion of the projectile is uniform motion. Yes. How many of you are not clear about this horizontal vertical thing? Let me know. They won't be asked for the examination, but for understanding thing. Examination, I will tell you what will be asked. Or is everyone clear? Not clear. Yeah. Good. I will tell you this thing. Is everyone clear with the projectile motion? Kindly be here for the 2 minutes. Projectile motion sends a shot put, correct? One guy is throwing something with the initial velocity or with the maximum velocity is trying to throw it. And after some time, it will come to the ground for rest. Correct? So I am converting this into a two-dimensional thing. So two-dimensional sense what? X and Y axis respectively. Again, he's throwing it with some velocity. So that velocity, I am cutting down to two things. Okay. One is what? The vertical component of the velocity, which is in Y axis, and horizontal component of the velocity into X axis. Vertical component is given as U sin theta. Correct? Horizontal is given as U cos theta respectively. So the point is that while this is going, the shot put or the ball or whatever it is going up, it should come down, correct? Why it is coming down? It is coming down due to the acceleration due to what? Gravity, gravitational force, it is coming down. The shot put is coming down, correct? So since it is coming down due to the acceleration due to the gravity, vertical component, this component, there will be a change. The acceleration changes for the vertical component. Okay, or the velocity with respect to time is changing for the vertical component. But if you look at the horizontal component, the velocity is not at all changing. Why it is not changing? Because the force acting on the projectile is only the force of gravity, and which is in the downward direction. Correct? So what is the horizontal component force? The horizontal component force is zero in this. That's the reason. Now is everyone clear? If you want me to the last, one more time I'll explain. Okay, maybe if you think, see, for the horizontal graph, right, there is no force acting on this horizontal thing. There is absolutely no force. So U cos theta is zero. This has got absolutely no impact on the movement of my shot put. The only thing which makes my shot put fall to the ground is what? Due to the acceleration due to gravity. So only the vertical component of the velocity is only changing. The horizontal component is zero actually. Are you clear now? Yeah. The force acting on the horizontal component is zero actually. There is nothing big thing in this. This is actually I can tell an 8th standard level thing. Simple as that. But the only new terms which I introduced here is what? Some cos theta and sine theta I told. I am dividing into two components, vertical component and horizontal component. I'm sure that most of you are hearing it for the first time. Vertical component, horizontal component, differentiation, integration. Okay, you will get used to this stuff. Clear? You will all get used to this stuff. So no need to worry at all. the only thing which I want to tell you or comfort you is, this is only for the board thing. Okay, fine. Entrance question, direct formula I'm going to give you. Once you written down each and everything in this, I will give you the thing. So if you want, for you guys, I'll just write down this thing. If you want, you can take a screenshot of the same also. Take a screenshot of the same if you want. Okay. The force acting is only vertically downward. That is, anyway, we know it is due to the axis due to gravity. Again, I'm writing down in simpler terms. Okay. Fine. That is acceleration due to gravity. So this is only the key point. So which means what? The horizontal component is zero, which means horizontal component is zero. How many, if you don't know how to take a screenshot, let me know that also. Yeah, fine. Is there anyone who does not know how to take a screenshot? Let me know the same. In computer, there is something called sticky notes. Not sticky notes, I think snipping tool is there. Okay, you can just type it out also. You can also cut it on whatever manner you want. Snipping tool or print screen or whatever it is. So if you're using an Android mobile, just use the three fingers and swipe up. iPhone, there is one more feature. If you don't know how to take screenshot, ask me, I'll help you out. So, but guys, but actual application of this is not in the javelin throw or shot put. It's for the, in the war, this is used. Okay, for the missile and everything. It is not for the actual use. Finished. If everyone has finished it down, then I'll go to the next thing. I'll tell you what is important. So if you got any doubt, I think once I finish the session, I'll tell you. Okay. At the end of the session, you can ask your doubt. Yeah. Fine. So I think everyone has written down. So I'm just going to the next page. Fine. Now, whatever I write, okay, in the last session also I told you what you should have, an A4 size paper for physics, chemistry, biology or maths. Biology I don't know, formulas will come, but still I'm telling you. Okay, for physics and chemistry you should have a piece of paper. For everything, whatever entrance examination you are doing, you should have a piece of paper for the same, so that we should be able to refer those formulas. So the next thing is, I want to tell you, time of flight. First, I'll write down whatever is the important formula. Later on, you can do it. The formula is T is equal to 2u sine theta by g. 2u sine theta by g. Time of flight formula. The next one is maximum height. Formula is h is equal to u square sine square theta by 2g. then horizontal range of a projectile. Horizontal range of a projectile. I'll explain each and everything, but first, what is important, I will write it here. R is equal to u square. This is u, okay, u square sine square or sine 2 theta by g. U square sine 2 theta by g. H is e square sine theta, sine square theta by 2g. This is please copy the down this thing. I'll tell you what is the importance of this. In entrance, class 11th. Okay, once you're moving to class 12, you'll be writing your entrance examination, right? So class 11th questions will be made something like attempting less than 10 seconds. We can do it in within less than 10 seconds. So for 10 seconds, if we want to do, we should have what? Direct formula. We should use direct formula. So they'll ask you to find time of flight. They'll give you the initial velocity u, then they'll just ask you to find time of flight. Because here in our entrance examination, they're trying to eliminate people. It is not to find the smartest. It is a process of elimination we are doing here. Okay, who is doing it more fast? Okay, who can compete in this kind? It's a different kind of examination altogether conducted over here. Okay. That's the time of flight. T is equal to 2u sine theta by g. Are you clear in this? Okay, I think everyone has done it. Now I'll explain you each and everything. What is the meaning of each thing? Okay. Time of flight. For that, again, I have to go back to the first diagram. This diagram. So it is nothing but what? The time required by the projector to reach the same level of projection. I'll write it down here in words. Time required by the projectile to reach the same level of projection. No one will ask you define time of flight in entrance examination. It will be only this formula. Fine. And if they ask you what is the maximum height in this particular thing, the maximum height h. This is my maximum height. So it is a maximum vertical distance traveled by the projectile from the point of projection. If this is the projection point, okay, the vertical distance, the highest vertical distance is called what? The maximum height, common sense. That's all that I don't need to write. Then horizontal range. That is something which you're hearing for the first time. So that is nothing but it is a maximum horizontal distance, for example, from this end O to this particular end. If I'm giving this end as OP, from OP, this is my range. So it is a maximum horizontal distance traveled by the projectile. Range is nothing but what? Maximum horizontal distance traveled by the projectile. So my question for you guys is now, okay, when is my range maximum? When will I get the maximum value of range? all of you, give me a try. When will I get the Rangers maximum value? I only got two answers till now. Let me check what is these things. When the vertical velocity is low. Yeah, you can type it now. So the correct answer I think one of my students has given. Okay, see, we have to just see this value, 2 theta, correct? Sine 90 value is what? 1. So theta value should be 45. This theta value should be 45. Then only I'll get the maximum range value. Fine. When will I get the maximum height? What value of theta? If I just make it somewhat level simplified, when will I get the maximum height? What value will I get the maximum height? I need answer from everyone on this. So for maximum range, theta should be what? 45 degree. So that's sine 90 I'll get. Sine 2 theta. Correct. Sine 2 theta is what? Sine 90 I'll get. But now for maximum height, it should be what? Theta should be 90 degree. Then only it will be sine 90 is equal to 1. Good. Correct. Sine 90 degree. So theta value should be 90 degree. That is my question. Yes, T means time of flight. One more question I'll ask you. When will the range be same? When will the, or at what value of theta, the range value will be same? At what value of theta, range will be same? So we have discussed about maximum range value, we'll get as theta is equal to 45, correct? When can we get the range value as same? What values of theta will get range values as same? So we know the angle 0, 30, 60, 45, 90. So in that thing, what values will get the range values? Or when will the range will be same? What value of theta? If I put 0, no, I need 2 values. Okay, I'm not asking about minimum. Range is minimum, I'm not asking. I am asking about the 2 values of theta I need. 2 values of theta. I'm not asking about minimum value. I'm asking about the range value should be same. 0 and 360 are not possible, first thing. So the only angle it will be same is what? 30 and 60. Because 30 and 60. Because sum is equal to what? 30 plus 60. Complementary angle. Correct? For the two angles of projection whose sum is equal to 90. That is called what? complementary angle. Complementary means 90. Only for these angles. See, and one more thing, for the guys who are giving 0 degree and 360 degree, we are actually applying for putting a missile from the top of a flight. Okay, so there is no way that we can put it in 0 or 360 degree. Fine. So practical application should be there for this. So answer is 30 and 60. This is for the entrance they can ask. But apart from all of these things, but in any of the entrance exam, I have not seen these kind of questions. Okay, I'm just giving you this an extra question. Every entrance thing, 1, 2, and 3. Out of these three things, one will definitely come. Even if you don't understand the question, not a problem. Okay. These three things are very important. Keep these things in mind. Fine, guys. So please write down these things. And once this chapter is over, we got circular motion, uniform circular motion, centripetal acceleration, everything. So that will be taken down in the next class. Or else in the Tuesday, I will be taking the first max session. Fine. So anyway. So coming to that particular thing. Now, whomever is having doubts can ask me the doubts.